What's up, Mom? Welcome back to Learning Physics with me. Today, we're going to be learning about pendulums. Pendulums are pretty cool because they're a lot like springs that we learned about earlier. They're both harmonic oscillators, which just means that they both repeat a certain pattern. But with springs, the spring was only operating in the y direction. Remember when the spring was dropped from the top? It oscillated up and down in the y direction only. But with a pendulum, it's going to start at one angle and it's going to swing back to the opposite angle and then repeat this pattern. So we're just going to have to change a few things. Instead of just regular velocity, we're going to have to find an angular velocity. And instead of force, we're going to be finding torque. First, let me show you what I mean by angular velocity. I'm going to show you how I got the function, and then we're going to go to the whiteboard and I'm going to show you how we find the derivative of that function and how it gives us velocity. First, let's take a look at the actual video of the pendulum swinging back and forth. It starts at that certain angle, dropped, and it reaches the opposite angle like we talked about earlier. And then on the right, it creates this graph, this harmonic looking graph. And it's very similar to the spring position versus time, but in our case now, it's angle versus time. Now that we have a graph, we can analyze it. Down here at the bottom, Tracker comes up with the formula or the function for it because of the way it is shaped. It knows that it's a harmonic function, and this is the formula for that. And here on the side, we can fudge the numbers until our purple lines match with the actual graph. And those are the actual numbers that we know will fit this function over here. And once we have those numbers, we can find the derivative and find the angular velocity.
Now we have the graph and a function to work off of. Let's find the velocity of this thing. Before we find the velocity of the pendulum, let's do a little review. Remember when I talked about the spring's velocity? Well, I wrote this down. The derivative of a position versus time graph is velocity. Well, we don't have a position versus time graph. We have the angle versus time graph. Well, the derivative of theta, which is that angle, versus time is angular velocity. So really, we can change this to linear velocity and keep this as angular velocity. Here is what I mean. So if we have a function that looks similar to this, which is what we had for the springs, we get the derivative of this function, which is velocity, and we get something that looks like this, and it will create a graph like this, a linear graph. And we get the velocity by rise over run or the change in y over change in x. Well, this week we have an angular velocity, so we're gonna get something that looks like this. This is what we came up with in that Tracker video. When we analyzed the graph, this was that function. Now, if we wanna take the derivative of that, we get what's called omega, which is represented by this W looking thing. So we take the derivative of this and we get omega. And that gives us our angular velocity. We can just plug a time in here for t, and we can get that velocity at that time. But we're gonna use this function here to plug into the computer code, and it will update with that delta t, that change in time. Every 0.1 seconds, it will come up with that new angular velocity. And that's how the computer will run the code. Okay, so we just found angular velocity. It was just like finding regular velocity. With the springs. The springs, we had position versus time graph, but this week we had an angle versus time graph. So we took the derivative of the angle versus time and found angular velocity. It's very similar with force and torque. With force is the derivative of momentum versus time. Well, what do you think torque will be? Torque will be the exact same thing, but it's the derivative of angular momentum versus time. I won't get too into finding torque because there's a very easy way to find it with the computer. All you have to do is find the cross product of the vector arm and the force of the pendulum. And the computer can do that for us, so I will not go to the whiteboard and show you how to do that. Now let's go to the code and get some results.
Here's the code for this week. I've highlighted the things that are important for this week and the things that we worked on earlier. Omega at the top, here we have the function that we created earlier, and that's the function that the code will update over that time. Now below the omega, we have the while loop, and these are the things that are different this week in our while loop. We have torque, omega, and theta. Torque is just the force for the pendulum. And remember when I said it's just the cross product of the vector, arm, and the force. And that's what's written here. And I didn't get too into that. But omega, this is how it is being updated in that while loop. Remember, omega is just the velocity, and velocity is force times that delta t. Well, this week we have torque times that delta t. And then theta is just the position, and position is velocity updated by that delta t, which is omega in our case now. Now we're going to run the code and see if it matches what we videoed, what we captured in the real world. So we start it and it oscillates back and forth. Now I set it to run for 2.5 seconds because that's what the video showed, and we saw two peaks in the real video. And it looks like we do have two peaks in the simulation as well. Now we're gonna check at about 0.6 seconds at the first peak and see what the angle is. And it looks like it's 1.2 radians. Now we're gonna compare this to the real world video that we captured and see if these angles match up. Now if we go back to the graph on tracker, we see that at 0.6 seconds, the angle was 67.7 degrees. And to find the radians, we multiply 67.7 times pi divided by 180, and it gives us 1.2 radians, which is exactly what we saw on the code.
And we're done. We got some spot on results with the computer simulation compared to the real world data that we got from Tracker. And we also learned that if we have an angle instead of position versus time graph, we can still find that velocity, but it's going to be angular velocity. And if we do have that angle, we're not looking for force anymore, we're looking for torque. And we saw how we can find both of those and plug them into the computer simulation and get the output that we wanted. Thank you for watching, and I hope you learned something.